Good afternoon. I hope that everyone is having an enjoyable and productive time at Discovery. Let me start off our luncheon and awards by giving a big thank you to today's luncheon sponsors, Tufsud, Gold Corp, and Lockheed Martin. I would like to extend a special welcome to the Hydrators, a team of 8 students from Halton Region who placed first for product innovation at the First LEGO League 2017 as part of the Animals Allies Challenge. Can the team please stand so we can congratulate you? I would now like to introduce Dr. Qing Liu, President of the Jiangsu Industrial Technology Research Institute, who will bring greetings from the Chinese delegation at Discovery.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. First of all, on behalf of the Chinese delegation, which includes the people from Tsinghua University, Peking University, Chinese Academy of Science, and other and many other universities and industries, I would like to thank OCE for organizing such an outstanding and a wonderful innovation event so that we can see and experience the latest innovation achievements in Ontario. I'm also very grateful to the Chinese Council in General in Toronto and the Ontario Ministry for Research, Innovation and Science for their support and assistance for the Chinese delegation to be able to participate in this conference. As we all know, China's reform and opening up policy over the past 30 years have enabled China's economy to develop at a rapid speed, and the quality of life for Chinese people has been significantly improved. At the same time, the Chinese development has also promoted the development and the globalization of the world economy. For example, last year, China produced and sold the cars that accounted for 32% of the world's total, reaching a record of 29 million vehicles. In only city in China, if you stand on the side of the motorway, every minute you will see Volkswagen, General Motors, Toyota, Ford, Hyundai, and so on, almost all the famous automobile brand in the world. So that you can see the China's opening really somehow closely related with the world economy. Today's China is undergoing a process of transformation and upgrading to a knowledge-based economy. China is committed to a fundamental policy of opening up and pursues a win-win opening strategy. I come from Jiangsu province. Jiangsu is the leading province in China in terms of economy and opening up. With 1% of the land and 6% of the population, Jiangsu contributes 10% of economy for the whole China. Actually, we also contribute 3% of total manufacture, 3% of global, 3% of the global manufacture industries. It has been 33 years. Ontario and Jiangsu has a friendly relationships. And the two provinces have also set up specially the fund, specially support innovation cooperation. My first visit to Canada was with the delegation of Jiangsu Province, Toronto, to attend the celebration of the 30th anniversary of the friendly relationships. During the past 3 years, Jiangsu Industry Technology Research Institute, we call it G3, has established cooperative relationship with the University of Toronto, Western University, University of Waterloo, and the Mars Discovery District. We organized a number of joint workshops in selected areas and have started a number of cooperative projects as well. Canada not only has rich natural resources, but also has a resource of education and innovation resource. Ontario is always considered as a global leader in innovation and the knowledge economy. This is my third time in Toronto to attend this OCE Discovery Conference. I'm particularly impressed with the innovation achievements in clean tech, ICT, and biomedical advanced manufacture, and so on. G3 has 39 special institutes in various fields with more than 6,000 researchers. As a bridge between the university and industries, G3, we have very close connections with our Jiangsu industries. G3 also plays a role bridging the global to the Jiangsu. We help the Jiangsu industries to find an innovation resource around the world, try to solve our technical needs for the development. On the other hand, we also like to help international companies to promote their products and technologies in Jiangsu and into the huge market with a population of 3.4 billion in China. Today's audience, I know, includes mainly high-tech startups companies and entrepreneurs. G3 would also like to bridge those startups and entrepreneurs to realize their dreams in China. I sincerely believe that if we promote opening, cooperative, and win-win innovation, we will certainly have a green, peaceful development and a better life for the tomorrow. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Liu. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce the Honorable Dr. Reza Moridi, Minister of Research, Innovation, and Science. Dr. Moridi's educational and professional background equips him with a rare expertise of being able to bridge the distinct worlds of science and business. His advanced knowledge and passion for innovation and science are evident in the work of his ministry. Ontario's innovation community greatly appreciates his ongoing efforts to build a thriving environment for all of our entrepreneurs and company. He is a true champion of innovation in this province and a friend to all of us in the innovation ecosystem. Please welcome the Honorable Dr. Reza Moridi.
Thank you. Well, thank you very much, Tom, for that very kind and gracious introduction. The Honorable Tracy MacCharles, Minister of Government and Consumer Services, Mr. Michael Nobrega, Chair of the OCE, Ontario Centres of Excellence, colleagues, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's truly a great pleasure to be back at OCE Discovery Conference 2018. And I want to begin by thanking Dr. Tom Corr, President and the CEO of Ontario Centres of Excellence, and his team for putting this remarkable conference together. I have been told that this year we have 3,800 attendees in this conference with 550 exhibitors. So this is the greatest OCE Discovery Conference ever. So congratulations, Tom, on this very successful Discovery Conference. I also want to take a moment to recognize that Toronto is located on the traditional territory of Indigenous people dating back centuries ago. And I want to show my respect for their contributions and recognize the role of treaty making in what is now Ontario. Hundreds of years after the first treaties were signed, they are still relevant today. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to the most impressive assembly of innovation you will find anywhere in the world. The Discovery Conference is like a crystal ball where we get a rare glimpse into the future. And from what I have seen on the show floor, there is much to look forward to. Some say the future is not written. But I can tell you right now, discovery proves that wrong. With over 500 exhibitors from an incredible range of sectors, from clean tech to transformative technologies, automation, aerospace, and even accessibility technology for people with disabilities. It is remarkable how far have come since the first discovery in 2006. Facebook had just launched for public use. The iPhone was still a year away. At Discovery 2009, we were introduced to first generation drones and 3D printing. Today, drones are being used in agriculture, surveying, and search and rescue. And 3D printing is being used in aerospace and automobiles and in healthcare to make prosthetic and new joints. You can easily purchase a drone or 3D printer on Amazon. Ladies and gentlemen, we have certainly come a long way. And today, Ontario is at inflection point. We can take a backseat to the next wave of innovation or be leaders. I think we all agree that leadership is the way forward. That's why Ontario has made significant investments in our future to ensure we are leaders in technologies that are advancing at an unprecedented pace. Compared to the Industrial Revolution, we are now entering an innovation revolution that will be estimated 10 times the pace and 300 times the scale. That's why Ontario has committed to investing in transformative technologies that will make a profound and positive change in industries such as healthcare, life sciences, finance, energy, transportation, manufacturing, and in our homes. So we are making significant investments in innovation in 5G technologies, artificial intelligence, quantum computing and quantum computers, genomics, stem cells and regenerative medicine, clean technology and cybersecurity, to lay the foundation for what is coming next and help our innovators succeed on a global scale. Ladies and gentlemen, with a background in science, I am especially interested in how technologies will transform our quality of life for the better. And we already have fantastic examples right here in our province of Ontario. Consider Winterlight Labs. Frank Rojish is a scientist at the Toronto Rehabilitation Institute and a professor at the University of Toronto. He is also a faculty member at the Vector Institute for Artificial Intelligence here in Toronto, which is quickly commencing Ontario as a leading international hub for artificial intelligent research. His company, Winterlight Labs, has developed a way of using machine learning to measure cognitive health by analyzing how people speak. Let's say a person is describing a family photo. AI is used to measure hundreds of things, including variations in pitch, vocabulary, and grammar. AI can then predict health issues such as depression and Alzheimer's disease. There are about 50 people using winter lights software in a senior's home in the city of Toronto. Residents say the test itself is less stressful and actually enjoyable as compared to the previous methods. Not only is AI helping pinpoint health risks, it is making healthcare more patient-focused. Another great example is Cloud DX out of Kitchener. They have developed a tricorder handheld medical device that can detect vital medical signs such as respiratory condition. Simply put, it connects the patient and the clinician anywhere at any time, even in the comfort of patient's home. It's a glimpse into a more effective, affordable, and fully connected healthcare system. And the Cloud DX technology was the much-deserved recipient of the International 2017 X Prize for Bold Epic Innovation. Ladies and gentlemen, these examples and the hundreds of others at Discovery show that technology can be a force for good, especially when it comes to saving our planet from the effects of climate change. A very interesting one is CHAR technologies. They are developing a technology that could eliminate up to 5.3 million tons of greenhouse gases from steel production in the province of Ontario by the year 2030. That is simply incredible. Our government is pleased to support projects like this one. CHAR is receiving government support through the Low Carbon Innovation Fund. And later today, my colleague, the Honorable Chris Ballard, the Minister of the Environment and Climate Change for the province of Ontario, and I will be announcing funding for a number of other clean tech projects. You know, Ontario has the fastest growing clean technology sector in Canada, with close to $20 billion in revenue, 5,000 companies, and 130,000 employees. In fact, we rank number 4 in the world in that particular sector. There is so much opportunity in the province of Ontario for clean technology. So it makes sense for this province to invest in clean tech. The province of Ontario has committed more than $400 million in a number of research and commercialization projects related to clean technology and the bioeconomy since this government came to the office in 2013. Our government's goal is to make the province of Ontario the best place on the planet to develop new technologies, products, and services, and also keep our planet intact. But we need the talent to get us there. And that's why we have prioritized advancing the skills and talents and education of our people. We have already ensured Ontario has one of the most highly educated workforce, not only in Canada, but in the world. So, ladies and gentlemen, now it is time to put that knowledge and expertise and training to work, and even as we expand our efforts to better prepare the next generation of Ontario's digital economy of the future. Because as we look into the crystal ball, that is discovery. We see the young people who will become the innovation leaders and the thinkers of our future. And I am confident that they will take us to a place we can't even imagine. I would now like, ladies and gentlemen, to introduce a video entitled Where the World is Going. This video tells an exciting story about our great province of Ontario. So I want to thank you. Merci beaucoup. Make which enjoy discovery. Thank you.
Have you seen the future? Have you seen where technology will take us? Or what innovation will bring us? You will, because it's happening right now. And it's happening right here in Ontario, Canada. From AI to machine learning to IoT, and from the over 15,000 startups to some of tech's biggest stars, here is where you'll find the world's first quantum machine learning startup program. And here is where people and ideas are welcomed from all over the world.
You ask the question, have I seen the future? I can now.
Ontario, Canada, where the world is going.
Thank you, Minister Moridi. Echoing our board chair, Michael Nobrega's comments from the opening ceremony, the progress made in innovation in Ontario is in no small part due to the tireless efforts made by Minister Moridi, and these efforts are equally appreciated by all of us. We are now ready to proceed with the awards presentation. I would like to invite the Honorable Tracy MacCharles and the Minister responsible for accessibility and Michael Nobrega to join Minister Moridi and me on the stage. We will begin with the Accessibility Tech Pitch Competition Awards. This showcase and pitch competition is being offered by OCE in partnership with the Ministry of Research, Innovation and Science and the Accessibility Directorate of Ontario. 34 Ontario-based companies are exhibiting their accessibility-focused innovations on the Discovery Show floor. Yesterday, 5 of the showcase companies pitched their ideas for the chance to win a $20,000 award. The finalists are Access Now, Braze Mobility, Steadyware, Tekla by Komodo Open Lab, and Trexo Robotics. Let's roll the video.
I'm the founder of Access Now. It's a mobile app and website that allows people to search for specific places like restaurants, hotels, stores, parks, and determine whether or not that place has the accessibility features that they need at that location.
So what Tekla is, it's an assistive device that helps people with mobility impairments to access mainstream technologies like smartphones, tablets, computers, and smart home devices.
My name is Manmeet, and I'm the CEO of Trexo Robotics. At Trexo, we're enabling walking for children with walking disabilities.
Today I'm going to talk about our brainchild, the Steady Glove, a smart glove that stabilizes the wrist, an essential tremor, and Parkinson's disease.
My name is Pooja Vishwanathan, and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Braze Mobility. We build innovative solutions to help increase safe and independent mobility.
The winner of this year's Accessibility Tech Pitch Competition is Steadyware, Inc. Mark Elias, CEO and co-founder, will you please come to the stage and accept the award? I would now like to introduce the Social Enterprise Pitch Competition. This showcase and pitch competition is offered by OCE in partnership with the Ministry of Economic Development and Growth. 21 Ontario-based companies are exhibiting their social innovations on this year's Discovery show floor. This morning, 5 finalist companies pitched their ideas for a chance to win an exciting award package. The finalists are Genesis, Envirotech, Growing North, Just Vertical Incorporated, Library in a Week, and New Grocery. Let's roll the video.
The Social Enterprise Pitch Competition celebrates the work of Ontario's social entrepreneurs and highlights the province's commitment to advancing social innovation.
We've redesigned hydroponic growing from the ground up to be something that not only functions well, it's something that not only tastes good, but looks amazing in your home. What we've done is we've fully integrated the scientific and design components of growing.
And although we compost and recycle, most of our waste is destined for landfill. That's where New comes in. New is Ontario's first zero-waste grocery store.
It became our mission to tackle food insecurity in Northern Canada. And we do this through greenhouse infrastructure, educational programming, and economic opportunities.
We all know that plastic pollution is a huge problem. It threatens the lives of over 700 marine species. Genesis is an organic waste processing company that converts food waste into high-quality, biodegradable plastics.
I found myself really asking the tough questions of life as to why am I here on the planet. And it hit me. I said, I'm here for something more than what I was allowing myself to do. Library in a Week was born, my friends. The model is built on 100% local empowerment, local people with me, shoulder to shoulder.
The competition winner will receive an award package valued at $20,000, including $10,000 from the Ministry of Economic Development and Growth and a $10,000 legal services package from Norton Rose Fulbright to assist with the further development of their social enterprise. The winner of this year's social enterprise pitch competition is Genesis Envirotech. Luna Yu, founder and CEO, will you please come to the stage to accept the award? Now, for the 6th consecutive year, we are pleased to announce our winners for the Young Entrepreneurs Make Your Pitch Competition. I will ask our winners to stay on the stage until the end of the award presentation for a group photo. The competition for Ontario high school students is presented by OCE and the Ministry of Economic Development and Growth. 20 finalists who were chosen through a combination of public and expert voting based upon a 2-minute video pitched their ideas to a panel of judges yesterday afternoon. On Sunday evening, the high school competitors attended a boot camp to polish their pitching skills. We welcome them to Ontario's entrepreneurial community. Cue the video, please.
I am Raquel Goka and my business is Rex. It is a nonprofit dance company that focuses on the art and authenticity of hip hop, as well as focuses on female empowerment.
My name is Luke Edward, founder and CEO of Booksmart, and I'm here to show you how you can save hours and hours of stress and pointless phone calls when booking appointments.
The cleansing kit is a box filled with treasures that will help you get rid of the ghost that is haunting your home.
My organization will help these young adults learn the fundamental skills of what it takes to become a successful adult.
It is a time for unity, where women of all ages can stand together and say, I am me, but stronger.
Univisor is a website that combines all the necessary and important information as an easy access point for students looking to study under one tab.
Imagine That is a virtual reality design shop that uses the latest cutting-edge technology to advance character design and creation.
Introducing MuLeaf, a compostable and biodegradable bowl made up of 100% clean and hygienic leaves.
This is a hockey stick holder for the interior of your car. It's straightforward and it works.
Early intervention is key when it comes to dispelling the gender stereotypes that prevent girls from seeing themselves as the really, really smart person, doctor, scientist, engineer, or programmer that they have the potential to be.
At Corfix, I feel it is an obligation to ensure that my customers leave not only a repaired phone, but with money in their pocket.
Gina provides a pathway for these aspiring artists, for these underprivileged children, to live their best lives.
Introducing Inspire, a nonprofit social enterprise. It's time to empower the next generation. It's time to work together to make a difference in our community. So let's inspire. Thank you.
The six winners will receive reserved entry into Summer Company, the province business program for young entrepreneurs, a $750 education voucher, and a Muse brain-sensing headband donated by Toronto-based Interaxon. Joining us now on stage for the presentation is Natalie Aries Matuthe, an electrical engineer from Interaxon. I will announce the winners and ask each of them to come on stage to accept the award and remain on stage for a group photo. From Markville Secondary School, Austin Chan and the Will This Course.
I just wanna feel this moment.
From St. Robert Catholic High School, Luke Edward from Booksmart. From Dunbarton High School, Yuma Hussein from Univisor. From Kingsville District High School, Molly Collier from Hockey Stick Holder. From Bell High School, Mackenzie Huckville, the Mighty Molecules Entertainment Company. From Mora Secondary School, Mackenzie McGuire with Imagine That. Please join me in congratulating the winners.
I just wanna feel this moment. I just wanna feel this moment.
I would also like to sincerely thank our competition judges who have generously lent their time and words of wisdom to our competitors. Thank you very much, judges. Thank you to Minister Moridi and Minister MacCharles and Natalie for being part of today's award presentations.